Hello to you, YouTube. It has been quite some time since I've picked up this camera. To be honest, I would say Arnold's would have been the last time that I picked this up, which was March. We are now in July, and I believe it's the 24th today. So what's that, March, April, May? It's 4 months roundabout since I picked this camera up, and I've been trying to tell myself to do it for the last week and a half, and I just haven't. And so today I just was like, I didn't want to do this in the car because I'm sitting in the car obviously, but I just needed to grab it and just start. And now that I've started, I'll be fine and I'll be able to keep on a roll. I'm just jumped in the car now because I'm off to the gym to train upper body. I'm training calves, back and shoulders today. I'm not going to be filming it because I'm training on by myself, and today I just sort of need to get in the zone and get shit done. Basically I am about 11 weeks out from the IFBB Pro League State Show, which means that I am 13 weeks out from Nationals, which is where I'll be going for my pro card again. I'm feeling really good. Really good. I have a lot to update this vlog on. I have a new coach, which has been absolutely fantastic. I'm engaged now. I have had my engagement party. I'm wedding planning like crazy. Yeah, there's just lots of awesome stuff happening, and Wow. I'm just glad that I've picked this camera up. Now that I've done this opening clip, I am going to go get this workout done, and then I will sit down at home and run through a whole heap of stuff that I need to go over. I've got a list of things that I want to update everyone on, as well as update you on this current prep that I'm in right now. But right now, I'm going to go get this workout done. I'm glad that I stopped procrastinating and picked this camera up finally to start this vlog, and I'm gonna go get shit done, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Hey guys, that is me, all done with my training. It's a few hours later now. Awesome training session. I'm really happy with that. It's funny because my weight this prep so far has sort of been chilling and not really dropping how we expected it to, but today as I was training I sort of noticed that one of my sort of problem areas at the moment, which is my biceps triceps sort of area, that's taking its time to sort of start leaning out. Actually looked a bit leaner today, which is awesome. Just a little bit more separation here around my bicep, underneath my bicep. So that's awesome. That made me really happy. But I'm gonna head home now, have my post-workout meal, grab my laptop, and I may do some work from home, or I might head up the street to a cafe and do some work there just to motivate myself a little bit rather than working from home, because sometimes I tend to get very distracted with housework. So yeah, I'm gonna go do that. I'm gonna show you my post-workout meal, which is very, actually no, I'm not gonna show you. It's so simple. It is literally chicken and basmati rice. So I'm gonna go eat that. I'm not gonna bother showing you because it's very boring. Hello guys. All right, so I just ate my meal and I'm sitting down in my living room, cuddled, snuggled up in a blanket, because it's actually freezing, not only outside, but in my house as well. We live in a really old house with very minimal heating, and therefore I spend all winter absolutely freezing my ass off. So don't mind me wrapped up here in a blanket trying to keep warm, but it's just, I need to, especially when on prep. Basically, like I said in the last clip, I put up a big questionnaire asking people what they wanted to know in this YouTube video. And it generally, what most people asked was just questions in regards to what's sort of been happening over the last few months, in regards to, well, everything, I guess. So first things first, I'm just going to go ahead and sort of explain a little bit about my last prep and what sort of happened to my footage. So essentially, I think I never put any New Zealand footage up, and I never put any Arnold's footage up. And basically what happened there, except for the makeup tutorial that I recently put up, I had downloaded everything from my camera onto my laptop and it all got lost, gone. So I left it sit there for a couple of weeks and I was gonna come back to edit it, and it's gone. So that was great. I feel like this has happened a few times now and it's quite frustrating, but it is what it is. So
Let's start fresh here, and hopefully I can get absolutely everything out to you. And lesson learned to me, don't leave it so long between uploading the content to my laptop and actually editing the videos to upload to YouTube. So my bad, that's what happened there. The next thing I sort of want to address is sort of what happened with my last comp season, because obviously the footage is gone. Basically, the first show that I had was the New Zealand, the Victorian Arnold Qualifier, which was late February in Melbourne, and I won that one. I won the open and division for that one, which was amazing. And then I went on to New Zealand the following week. No, 2 weeks later. Went over to New Zealand. I was in the height class B, and I came runner-up in my height class. So that wasn't the outcome that I was exactly after. Over there, I was hoping to get the pro card because it was an international show that had a pro card on offer. But that didn't matter because I had Arnold's the following week to come back for. During the start of the week, I felt really, really good. And then towards the end of the week, and especially on show day, as the day went on, I just didn't bring my best. Essentially, I'll throw some photos up here so that you can see. But basically, when I went on stage, I was holding quite a lot of fluid, especially in my legs, and you can actually see it in my face. Now, in the past, I've worn my hair straight on stage, and more recently, I've done like a loose curl, and then the curls for Arnold's were a little bit tighter, so I think that has contributed to how puffy my face is looking, is that the curls sort of round out my face, but I'm not, like, aside from that, I'm still... My face is so fluidy and puffy, and it's really, really obvious in those photos that I just wasn't myself on that day. My physique wasn't the best it could have been. And I didn't actually place. I think when I looked up the results, I might have come eighth in my heart class, which was medium. Anyway, I just didn't bring the physique that I should have or could have. And I guess that was a lot of lessons learned from that show. Since then, I have actually signed on with a new coach, Troy Thornton. I've been working with him since April. He's based in Melbourne. He coaches a few of these Aussie pros and has quite a strong team of girls. I've known him for a little while and sort of chatted back and forth and really appreciated his opinion. He was a judge in the past, and he specializes in bikini girls. And he's a lot OCD with how he works with physiques, which is fantastic. That's what I'm after. And I guess I changed coaches because I didn't get the results I wanted in terms of my physique. So obviously I was after the pro card and I didn't get that result. However, the reason for that is my physique just wasn't where it could have been and where it should have been. And I can tell you right now, I worked my ass off last prep. And when you've given absolutely everything, worked your ass off and still not achieved the result in the physique that you end up bringing to the stage, it's extremely disheartening and disappointing. And I knew that day that I just didn't bring the package that I could have and one that I could be proud of. I recently looked back on some of just the footage that I had on my phone from check-ins backstage, and I even look unhappy. Like, usually show day, I love show day. I'm excited, I have a lot of fun, I feel great, I smile a lot backstage, and you can just see in the videos, I'm just really unhappy and sad. Like, there's no other way to put it. And really, I should not have been unhappy and sad that day. I mean, I got engaged 2 days prior to that, so I should have been like running on fumes. Like, I should have been so happy that weekend, and I just wasn't myself. I did not feel ready at all. And obviously the stage photos show that I wasn't, my conditioning wasn't anywhere near where I should have been. I should have been a lot leaner. In fact, I was probably maybe 3, maybe 4 kilos off where I really should have been. And don't get me wrong, I look pretty good, but no way near where I should have been and no way near the standard that I should have been at with my physique at that time. So that's my reason for switching coaches. I needed some new methods, someone local who I could actually drive and see. Melbourne's about 2 hours from where I am, so I can physically go and visit Troy and say, have a look at me, let's pose for you, have a look at me, what do we need to do, happy with how I'm progressing. because it's more than achievable to prep someone online, but nothing beats being able to see someone in person. So that's my reasoning for changing coaches. So I have been working with Troy since April, as I said, and since then I've seen some absolutely ridiculous changes. We've brought my calories up from somewhere around 1400 and brought them right up around 2.5, maybe a little bit more than that, which was fantastic, and actually got leaner in the process. In the probably 2 to 4 weeks following comp, I put on 7 kilos, and I just felt, I actually didn't feel too bad, but I definitely looked puffy and just not where I should have been that close post show. And signed on with Troy and tightened up a little bit and increased calories, and actually, yeah, definitely got noticeably leaner in that time. The areas that we've sort of been focusing on have been my glutes, because as a bikini athlete, that's where it's at. So we've been focusing on my glutes, my outer hamstrings, bringing up my calves, and of course my shoulders. Not only were they not big enough, I just wasn't full on stage, so that you weren't actually able to see how big they really were and the shape that I was. So it's been good to be in an off season and actually have full muscle bellies to actually make a good judgment on how my physique is looking. So they're the areas that we've been working on: outer hamstring, glutes, shoulders, and calves. And we've made some awesome changes in terms of my glutes. I might flash a photo up here that I've got of my glutes, little mini transformation that I sort of made with doing a 3 to 4 week period where we were literally just focusing on glute growth, and it's been so beneficial. My physique has changed. Just those mini, like tiny little tweaks that made a huge difference to how your overall physique looks in terms of balance. And yeah, I think that by the time I get on stage next, I'm going to look like an entirely different person. Not only that, but Troy is the king of conditioning. His girls get on stage shredded and full. Shredded and full. So I'm really excited to see what him and I can achieve this prep, and see how I look actually lean and with this amount of muscle that I'm carrying now. Because I mean, I competed last July and I was very lean then, but I was also a lot smaller in terms of muscle size. And it'll be really, really nice to, yeah, to see how I look shredded and full, but with carrying more muscle, with better shape, improved posing as well. That's a huge thing. I've been working on my posing like a mad woman, just to really level up. I mean, my posing, I was pretty confident in the past anyway, but that doesn't mean that it can't be better. I'm a huge believer that, you know, things can always be improved, even if it's just that 1% or even less, 0.5%, little things that can make that slight minute difference, and they all add up to make a huge difference overall. So I've been working really hard on my posing. So that's a bit of an update on my life right now. Last month, end of June, we had our engagement party as well. And that was kind of in the middle of prep. But I had said to Troy, I'm not going to prep unless I can have this night with my family. So what we ended up doing was I depleted for the week into my engagement party, and then I was able to have dinner and have a few drinks. And we actually had a really big night, which was a lot of fun and so totally worth it. And what's hilarious is my weight actually dropped, obviously dehydration as well, but it stayed down after that engagement party. So that was fantastic. To know that one night wasn't entirely detrimental to the process. But other than that, I have been strict with my prep so far. I'm not having any cheat meals, just structured refeeds. And that's only as Troy deems necessary. I think I've only had maybe 2 to 3 in the past few months of actual structured refeed where he said, okay, have a high carb day today. At the moment, my cardio is pretty minimal. In off season at the moment, I'm still maintaining 2 HIIT sessions a week, and that has stayed the same. So that's my baseline of cardio, is those 2 HIIT sessions. And at the moment, I'm just doing 45-minute slow cardio, so this each morning. And that's either for me a very brisk walk outside, or I'll get on the cross trainer or a spin bike at the gym if it's raining outside, because I'm a bit of a sook when it comes to the weather. But that's all I'm really doing at the moment. In terms of my food, I won't speak on specific numbers and amounts of food that I'm having, because it's very individual, very unique to each person. But what I will say is I'm eating more than I was last prep and definitely looking better. I mean, I've already beaten my Arnold's physique, hands down. In a future vlog, I will do a physique update so that you can see how I'm looking. But this probably won't be in this vlog, and it won't be today. Anyway, it won't be today. But I'm feeling really, really good so far. We are, in terms of prep, not ahead of schedule, not behind per se. We're pretty much bang on. However, I would have liked to have been a little bit ahead of schedule just for my peace of mind. But essentially, I have this sense of urgency at the moment where I can't take my foot off the accelerator because I will get behind. So I'm pushing really hard each day, trying to make sure that every day I'm bringing a new level of intensity to my training sessions. Oh, that's the other thing. My volume in my training sessions is very high right now, which is great, because it means that I'm burning more fat in my training sessions than I would have otherwise if I was just doing the amount of volume that I was before. Generally, my workouts would have been between 20 and 25 sets, and now they're up around 30 or 40 sets, depending on the day. And I found that to be really effective. I finish my sessions and I'm absolutely ruined. So yeah, that's where I'm at with my prep. It's probably enough of me talking. I've been going on for about 12 minutes now. I'm gonna sit down at my laptop and get some work done. I decided I'm gonna stay home and work rather than go to a cafe. I would say that that might be it for today. I won't have anything else to update you on, but in terms of today, all I have left is to do some work on my laptop, and I have a client later tonight. Later this week, I am heading off to Melbourne to support a few friends who are competing and fellow Team Destroy athletes who are competing at the mid-year pro qual, the IFBB mid-year pro qual. Massive shout out to my girl Taylor, who I'm staying with on Friday, who is looking ridiculous. And just quietly, I'm pretty sure she's gonna get the pro card this weekend. So I'm just gonna call that one now, and you've got it on video. It is Wednesday the 24th and she competes on Saturday. She's gonna win the pro card. It's happening. So I'll be staying with her Friday, Saturday. And I've also got a posing lesson with IFBB Bikini Pro Renee Garner from Perth. She's flying over to run some posing lessons, so that will be really interesting for me to learn some stuff. Other than that, I've still got to update you on right now, and I'll see you when I pick up the camera next.